गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर नितेश कुमार मिश्रा। हाउ आर यू? फाइन, थैंक यू। आई एम आल्सो फाइन। इन प्रीवियस क्लास आई टॉक्ड यू अबाउट एनालिसिस ऑफ सिंपल सेंटेंस, द बेसिक पॉइंट्स। टुडे वी डिस्कस नेक्स्ट स्टेप अबाउट इट्स। Okay, we have seen that the predicate may consist of one word or several words. When the predicate consists of one word, that word is always a verb, because we cannot say anything without using a saying word. That means a verb. When the predicate consists of several words, the essential word in the predicate is always a verb. As the verb is the essential word in the predicate, it is sometimes called the predicate verb. Okay? Just as the subject word may be qualified by an adjective or adjective equivalent, The verb in the predicate may be qualified by an adverb or adverbal equivalent called in analysis its extension or adverbal qualification. As the flames spread everywhere, we went home, he rose to go. The flames spread in every direction. Spring advancing, the swallow appear. In the sentence, you see where is subject and predicate. The flames, the attribute, and flames, subject word. So the flames is subject. Spread everywhere. Predicate. Here, spread is verb and everywhere adverbal qualification. So, spread adverb is known as predicate. In next, he went home. Here, he subject. Went verb or home is adverbal. So, you say here, he is subject and went home is predicate. In next, he rose to go. Here, he subject and rose to go is predicate. Rose is verb and to go is adverbial qualification. Okay. Flames, the spread in every direction. Here, flames, the subject. Here, the is attribute and flames is subject word. Spread in every direction is predicate. Spread is verb and every direction is adverbial qualification. In this sentence, you noted something? Oh, yes. In first sentence, the adverbial qualification is an adverb. And in second, the adverbial qualification is an adverbial accusative. In third, the adverbial qualification is a gerundial infinite. And in fourth sentence, the adverbial qualification is a group of words doing the word of an adverb. And in the fifth, the adverbial qualification is an absolute phrase. Okay, point out the adverbial qualification in each of the following sentences and say whether it is an adverb, an adverbial accusative or gerundial infinite, a group of words doing the words of an adverb or an absolute phrase. Okay, so please note it. He spoke distinctly. He spoke in a distinct voice. The boy ran a mile. The postman called again. He has come to stay. Wait a minute. The book is printed in clean type. I recognize your voice at once. Help a lame dog over a stile. The tide having turned, the ship set sail. He sold his horse below its value. He leaves two children behind him. He gets his living by trade. He made his money by trade. The enemy disputed the ground inch by inch. He saw a new world spread about him. The village life suited him in all respects. Him will I follow to the ends of the earth. Do you know what is complement? What is required to complete the predicate is called a complement. The complement of an intransitive verb serves to describe the subject and is therefore called a subject complement. Now, examine the predicate in the following sentence. The sky grew dark. Venus is a planet. It is I. The man seems worried. Your book is there. The horse is too late. The building is in a dilapidated condition. Here, subject, sky, attribute, the, and predicate, verb grew, or complement, dark. The sky grew dark. Okay. In second sentence, Venus is a planet. Here, Venus is subject, is verb, a planet is complement. And third, it is I. Here, it is subject, is verb, and I is complement. The man seems worried. Here, man, subject word, attribute the. Seems, verb, and complement, worried. And next, your book is there. Here, your attribute, book is subject, is verb, and there is complement. The house is too late. Here, the attribute, house, subject, word, is verb, too late, is complement. The building is in a dilapidated condition. Here, the attribute, building, subject, word, is verb, and in a dilapidated condition is complement. Okay, so what you see in the sentence? At first, the complement is an adjective, and in the second, the complement is a noun, and third, the complement is a pronoun, it is I, and fourth, the complement is a participle, and the complement is an adverb. And sixth, the complement is an infinitive. And last, seventh, the complement is a group of words doing the work of an adjective. When the predicate is completed by an adjective, such an adjective is said to be used predicatively or to be a predicative adjective. When the predicate is completed by a noun, the noun is said to be a predicative noun. Okay? So, you do some work. So, please note and pick out the complement in each of the following sentences and say whether it is a noun, an adjective, or a pronoun. Okay? So, please note. John became a soldier. Roses smell sweet. The child appears pleased. The workman seems tired. The earth is round. He looks happy. Sugar tasted sweet. The old woman is dead. The weather was cold. He becomes unconscious. The old gentleman is of a gentle disposition. The child is there. The children look healthy. Today she seems sad. The cup is full to the brim. Okay? So, you do this sentence at your home and pick the complement. Where is complement in the sentence? And you also say whether it is a noun, an adjective, or a pronoun. Then it is very interesting for you. Okay? Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye.